We continue our conversation now with Delaware Congresswoman Lisa Blunt Rochester. I want to talk about some of the committees and some of the issues you're directly involved in. I know in your committee there was a vote for a reduction in funding for the SNAP program, and they were taking the money and giving it to training, job training. On its face, that seems like a great idea.
That's right.
To get people off welfare and working, but you have a problem with it.
So just to put it in perspective, I'm on two committees. I'm on the House Committee on Education and the Workforce. So jobs and education are important. But I'm also on the House Committee on Agriculture, which historically is one of the most bipartisan committees in Congress, which is one of the reasons I fought to get on it. I was the last Democrat selected on that committee, and I begged everybody because it's so important to Delaware. It's our family farms, it's biotech, it's our land-grant institutions. But 77% of that budget for agriculture goes to our SNAP program, formerly known as food stamps. There is a proposal on the House Republican side that would mandate certain kind of work requirements. Most of the people are already working. Most of the people on SNAP are children, seniors, and people with disabilities. So the question was, okay, if we want to have a program that's going to focus on work, let's do what makes the most sense. We're all supportive of work. But one of the challenges is the way this program is structured, it would be about $30 per month to try to train individuals who may have challenges. And it's not even what the average program would, because I come from a labor background and a health and social services background, so I know what good programming is like. So, and it also creates a massive bureaucracy. So we're saying, why would we do that without testing it? Right now, there are 10 pilots across the country that are looking at best practices for job training. Delaware is one of them. The results of those pilots aren't due until 2019. So my question to the committee was, why would we put the cart before the horse? It's not good government. It's not good policy. And so, unfortunately, the farm bill, which is what this is a part of, came out of committee about a week or so ago on a partisan basis. And it was heartbreaking to our ranking member because he is a person who's into doing this in a bipartisan way. This has always been a coalition of urban and rural Democrats and Republicans. And unfortunately, that was not the case. So this bill, the farm bill, this month will go to the bigger Congress, to the floor, potentially this month. And so people should stay tuned. They should stay engaged and see, you know, what impact will this have on not just them, but, you know, all of us. I mean, it's our land grant institutions. It's our crop insurance and family farmers. And it's a really important piece of legislation. And we're hoping that we can come together. The Senate side is good. The Democrat and Republican are working together in a bipartisan manner. We just want to see that same thing on the House side.
And that's what a lot of people are saying. They're saying even if you don't like this bill now, it still has a lot of steps to go through. And by the end, it either is going to be killed or there's going to be some type of compromise along the way. What's fascinating about the bill that I saw is that on its face, it does look like a good idea. On its face.
Right.
And yet the money that goes for job training, it's almost
insufficient.
It goes to $1 billion from like $90 million to $1 billion. So it doesn't necessarily save money.
Right. Well, and some will say that that's not even the intention. Our thing is, if you're going to do something, let it be based on best practice. Let it be based on the evidence, the learnings that we get. And coming from a background dealing with labor and having been in state personnel, I felt it was a missed opportunity because we have unfilled jobs and we have a skills mismatch with individuals. If we really are serious about this, then we really need to put the resources to it and do it right.
We'll continue the conversation in just 1 minute. I want to get to, there's not a whole lot going on in Washington these days. I want to get your opinion on some of the issues that are covered by CNN and MSNBC. When the Delaware Way continues with Congresswoman Lisa Blunt Rochester right after this.